Hey everyone, it's Victor Didach. Hope you all have a great day. Today I want to talk about two words you should not say to yourself because they're often very destructive. And those are the words, I can. Very often people say to themselves, I can't do this, I cannot do that. I can't meet Mr. or Mrs. Right. I can't be successful. I can't find the perfect job. And because they're focusing on what they can do, they very often are not able to do it. Now the thing is, you were not born this way. You know, when you were a baby, you had no limitations. You tried to try different things, such new things. You know, even when you tried to learn how to walk, you didn't let the fact that you kept falling stop you from continuing to want to learn how to walk. So what happened? As you started getting older, people like your parents, your schoolmates, your teachers, people in institutions you belong to started telling you, don't do this, you can't do that. So as you started getting older, you started developing limiting beliefs as to what you were not able to do. So you didn't try doing these things because you felt you could not do them. And the thing is, you're capable of doing much greater things than you realize. And I'll give you an example. There was this woman, Laura Schultz. In 1977, she was 63 years old, and she picked up the back end of a Buick car to get it off her grandson's arm. Now, the interesting thing is, before this woman had never lifted anything heavier than a 50-pound bag of pet food. She was later interviewed by Dr. Charles Garfield, and she started asking, did I waste my life? Because for all my life, I've been not doing things because I didn't think I was capable of doing them, but I picked up this car, which I never before would have thought I'd been capable of doing. And Dr. Garfield was able to convince her that it was not too late to try new things. He got her to admit that she wanted to study geology. So he convinced her to go back to college and get a degree in geology. And several years later, she became a teacher of geology. So it shows you, it's never too late. So if you're right now thinking you can't do it, don't. Start realizing that you're capable of doing great things. In fact, when you say the words, I can't, it actually makes you physically weaker. Now, have someone take your arm, and I'll give you an example. You know, when you say the words, I can do it, your arm feels stronger. When you start saying out loud, I can't, your arm starts feeling weak and starts going down a little bit. Try it. Have someone hold your arms and do it. And so it affects you both mentally and physically. You know, one thing that I did that started to make me realize I'm capable of greater things was going to a Tony Robbins seminar earlier this year. You know, I went to that event where he teaches you how to walk on burning coals. Now, the purpose of walking on burning coals is not to walk on burning coals, but to make you realize that most of the things that stop you are in your mind, that you're capable of doing greater things. So when I walked through the burning coals, it made me realize that there are many things I can do, and that, you know, if I start believing in my mind, I can do them. And those of you, some of you out there have been to a Tony Robbins seminar and have walked on burning coals, and you know what I'm talking about. And if you've never done it and Tony comes to your local area, I highly recommend doing it. It would definitely make you realize, it will make you believe in yourself more, make you realize you're capable of doing greater things. So what I want to leave you with, is never say the words, I can. You're capable of doing great things. Instead, say, I can do it, I can do it, and you will realize you can do most of those things. This is Victor signing off. Have a great day.